This is Ravi. I completed my M.Tech from Central University Hyderabad. I done my two attempts in civils from the last 5 years, but I failed in the second level. My time doesn't permit for me. Now I'm interested in an area where I am working with my bosses, employability and employment. This is the area where I am concerned and working from the long time. I have been close with the colleges, say engineering colleges most of the times. Many people are concerned with these engineering education is it's useless nowadays. But that perception would be wrong in very soon, not much time takes, because every college goes under the single entity, that is only one university. If it is dividend to a number of trees, the quality would be much better. So in this area, we want to put much better efforts. We are working on. This is a short. As we all know that India is a developing country. Since how many years you have been listening the same word? Might be our grandfathers told to our parents took from us. Probably the next generations also it may travel. We are not hoping that, but it's happening nowadays. So why it has been like this? So we got independence in 1947. From there onwards, we got many reforms in different areas to get the development. At the time, our delegates introduced a few concepts like 5-year plans to develop in various platforms like Panchayati Raj system, development of courts, everything. They built enormous structure, but is that happening in a proper way? In these ways, our political system, since our country is known for democracy, is our politicians doing justice for us? Obviously no. Everybody can say that very directly and openly. But we are here to question, because when they come for vote, asking a vote, as we all know that these elections are the costliest elections ever happened, 2014 elections. So the minimum cost of an MP, he's spending minimum 5 to 10 crores for his election campaigning or his crew or to maintain or to facilitate in a number of ways. Like that an MLA, he's spending minimum 5 crores. So according to this information, minimum 10,000 crores were spent personally by politicians to contest in these elections. So if you multiply these amounts into, see how much big figure it is. Officially it is announced that just 10,000 crores. So my expectation is, why can't politicians start doing the activities instead of buying a vote from a voter? Like some ex-politician is there, why can't he hire a village and develop a village with that amount what he is spending in the election? 10,000 crores, 10,000 villages. 1 crore is not enough to develop a village, to have the minimum requirements. What are the minimum requirements we need to live? Everybody know that food, water and shelter. Can't he do this with 1 crore rupees for a small village? If he was successful in doing these kind of activities, he no need to at least go for a speech or a public addressing or anything else. Automatically water walks in. Nothing is required for an voter to get motivated or get, what we say, water is matured enough nowadays. As we all know that in 2004, before elections, the voting percentage was only 50, 69. Gradually it is increasing now. Our election commission did an enormous job in these elections, that they spent much, much money in making these let's vote, letting them know the value of the vote. these kind of activities are going on, but they are spending an unnecessary amount of money as a flow. No restrictions were made on these. If an MP is allowed to spend only 60 lakh rupees, instead of that he is spending 6 crores to 10 crores. Like the same way, some political parties are announcing different types of schemes which are impossible. Everybody knows that it's impossible. In Andhra Pradesh, Runamafi. How can it be possible? Every educated knows that it's impossible. It's highly impossible. As one of our friends shared us, there is no use of doing this kind of things. According to my personal interest, Election Commission should be very conscious that any political party announcing these kind of programs, they should be highly disqualify that party from the elections. They will be very conscious next time. They will not keep these kind of things into their manifesto, making people fade with their unfaith news. They are sending very wrong message that impossible things to be possible. In this way, if political transformation is done, we can grow very fast, we can be much more the living, the lifestyle and whatever may be, what not. Why we are lagging behind? We are nowhere lagging, but our system is forcing us to be lag. Water is matured enough, nothing to motivate water nowadays. Political parties should be motivated, they should open their eyes now. It's time for them at least to think from now onwards. So this is the message, finally, that thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. So everybody is done. So finally, please use, as we all used this opportunity, let our friends, our relations and the capable persons who are eligible, who can come out and be the better citizens for the coming nation, please introduce and make them know about the media junction, walk them in and let them also be proactive and be a participant of this nation to build a good career personally, and as well as they need to prove as a citizen, as we are all proving. Let them also know the opportunity, spread the word. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.